Hello students, welcome to SYFT Skilled Youth for Tomorrow. Data sufficiency has become a topic of high importance in quantitative aptitude section. For past few years, data sufficiency requires better understanding of the chapter as well as the concept of applying data sufficiency tricks. In this lesson, we will learn basic terminologies related to data sufficiency. What is data sufficiency? Data sufficiency by definition means reducing the sufficiency of information in answering the given problem. Data sufficiency questions consist of a question followed by two, three, or more statements. The task is to decide whether the information in the statements taken singly or together is sufficient to answer the question or not. These questions do not require calculation but evaluation of statements. Data sufficiency questions can be based on mathematical concepts as well as reasoning concepts. For example, a data sufficiency problem can be based on determining the speed of a train, while another could be on determining the direction of a moving person. Data sufficiency is an important part of quantitative aptitude section of every competitive exam. In almost every exam, several questions surely come from data sufficiency. Most of the candidates try to solve data sufficiency questions by guesswork. As each question carries some marks, questions in this part also deserve some time. Instead of guesswork, use a simple strategy as given below and avoid guessing the answer. Here are a few tips to solve two or three statement data sufficiency problems. And these are: never try to calculate the final answer as it is not asked. You need to find whether the information provided is enough to solve the given problem or not. Solve question step by step. First, try to find answer using first statement, then second, and then third. Finally, with different combination. Then mark your answer. Even if you find answer with only one statement, then try to find answer with remaining statements, as sometimes there is an option that answer can be found with both statements or all statements separately. Here are few basic steps which you need to follow while solving the data sufficiency questions. Read the given problem. Don't assume anything except universal facts. Take the first statement and combine it with main statement. Try to find the answer. If you are unable to find the answer, using second step, then combine second statement and combine it with main statement, and then try to find answer. If you are unable to find an answer, using second statement, then add both statements with main statement and try to find answer. This is also applicable if that is a three statement data sufficiency problem. If even then you can't find answer, simply tick both or all statements are insufficient to find the answer. Here we are solving some basic questions related to data sufficiency to give you the better clarity. In this question, the question is asking, what is the principle? Here three statements are given. First is the compound interest on the sum in 2 years at 10% per annum is ₹5,250. The second one is saying that the sum doubles itself in 8 years at 12.5% per annum at simple interest. The third statement is saying the simple interest received at 8% per annum in 2 years is ₹160 less than the compound interest on same sum at 8% per annum in 2 years. The options are given here like this. Either 1 or 3 is sufficient to answer. Both 1 and 2 together are sufficient to answer. Both 2 and 3 together are sufficient to answer. And both 1 and 3 together are sufficient to answer the question. Either 1 or 2 is sufficient to answer the question. The options generally are very confusing in all the questions of data sufficiency. So we need to go through them carefully. Let's start with explanation. From statement 1, it is stated that the compound interest on the sum in 2 years at the rate 10% per annum is ₹5,250. So here the compound interest amount is given ₹5,250, rate of interest 10%, and the time is 2 years. So the formula for compound interest is P into 1 plus R by 100 into T minus P. All the values are given in the statement itself, so we can easily calculate principal from this statement. From second statement, which states that the sum doubles itself in 8 years at 12.5% per annum at simple interest. The formula for simple interest is P into R into T by 100 is equal to P. So here in the statement, R is given 12.5% and T is given 8 years. But the amount of simple interest is not given in the statement. So the above equation will be true for all values of P. Hence, the principal cannot be determined from this statement. The third statement is saying that the simple interest received at 8% per annum in 2 years is rupees 160 less than the compound interest on same sum at 8% per annum in 2 years. From this statement, we know that for 2 years, difference between compound interest and simple interest will be P into R by 100 into 2. And we are given the difference and rate of interest, so principal can be calculated from this statement. Hence, we see that either statement 1 or 3 is sufficient to answer the question. So the correct answer is option 1. This question is asking that what is the number? Here in this question, we need not to find the number because it is a data sufficiency question. We need not to find the number. We need to find that the which statement we require to find the number. So the first statement is saying the sum of the two digits is 8 and the ratio of the same two digits is 1:3. And the second statement is saying the product of the two digits of a number is 12 or the quotient of two digits is 3. So two statements are given here. The options are saying one alone sufficient while two alone not sufficient to answer. Two alone sufficient while one alone not sufficient to answer. Either one or two alone sufficient to answer. Both one and two are not sufficient to answer. And both one and two are necessary to answer. We will evaluate the statements. First, we will take the first statement, which is saying the sum of the two digits is 8 and the ratio of the two digits is 1:3. Let's assume that the tens and units digit be x and y respectively. Then, by this statement, we are getting that x plus y is equal to 8. From that, we can say that x is equal to 8 minus y. And it is also there in the statement that x by y is equal to 1/3. So now, we'll put the value of x here in this place. So 8 by y minus y is equal to 1/3. We'll simplify the equation. By simplifying this equation, we'll get that 4y is equal to 24. So y will be 6. You can go through the calculations here. So we'll get the value of y from this equation. So now we know the value of y. So we can find the value of x because it is given that x plus y is equal to 8. So x plus 6 is equal to 8. Then x will be 2. Let's evaluate the second statement, which is saying that the product of two digits of a number is 12 and the quotient of two digits is 3. So it is given that x into y is equal to 12. So by this, we'll get the value of y, which will come to 12 by x. And it is given that x by y is equal to 3 by 1. So we'll put the value of y here. So x by 12 by x is equal to 3 by 1. And now by simplifying this, we'll get that x square will be 12 into 3, which will come to 36. And then the value of x will be 6. So we can calculate the value of y, which will come to 2. Please go through the calculation here. And therefore, either 1 or 2 alone sufficient to answer. Thank you very much for staying with us and for watching this lesson. Please do write us your suggestions. We'll be pleased to help you. Till then, enjoy learning with SYFT.